Welcome to the third lesson in the Google Ads tutorial series. In this video, we're going to create our first ad group. You can think of an ad group as a folder inside your campaign. Each ad group can contain one or more ads, along with the keywords you want to use for your ads to display as people are searching. Apart from creating our first ad group, we're also going to cover the different ways you can match your keywords to what people are searching for on Google. We're also going to cover assigning a budget to your campaign. If you've missed the tutorials covering the steps to create your account and set up your first campaign, you can find links in the description below this video. Now let's head to Google Ads. We're about to create our first ad group in our new campaign, and we're asked to enter some details. We need to enter the landing page we want to send people to on our website when they click our ad. And we're asked to describe why our product or service is unique. And I'm going to enter some details about why the offer is unique. Now let's click Generate. This takes us to the next step where we create our first ad group. Based on the landing page and details I've entered, Google's AI will provide some suggested keywords and will also try to write some elements for our ad. It's worth trying this, but it's probably a good idea to enter your own keywords and write your own ad copy, as results can vary. Okay, now you might be wondering, what are ad groups anyway? Well, ad groups are subfolders that are stored inside the campaign. Ad groups are used to organize and group the keywords we are going to be targeting with our search campaign. So what I want you to do is start thinking about the types of keywords that relate to your offer. Think about the types of things you expect people to be searching for on Google. Once you have an idea of the types of keywords you want to target, you can create different ad groups to divide your keywords into groups. Since this can be a bit tricky to get right before you've really researched your keywords, my tip here is that you can create a general ad group, and then once you've finished creating the campaign, we can jump back in and finish creating ad groups. For my landing page, it's suggesting some very general keywords, so let's remove these. And let's close the chat panel too. We're going to keep things simple, so let's name this ad group General. We can adjust the landing page URL. And we can enter the names of our product or service. We're going to use the keyword planner after we've created our campaign, so let's just enter three closely related keywords to start. For my ad group, I'm going to enter Google Analytics Glossary, GA4 Glossary, and Google Analytics Glossary of Terms. These keywords will be added as broad match by default. This basically means that Google Ads will try and achieve the most coverage for those terms as possible. So our ads will show on the keywords we've entered, along with any variations that Google feels relate to our keywords. This means as broad match keywords, my ads might show on Google Analytics Glossary, Google Analytics Terminology, GA4 Glossary PDF, Analytics Terminology, and a range of other related keywords. Now this can be a good thing because it increases the visibility of our ads, but it can also be a bad thing. We might show for search terms that are not expected and don't relate as well to our ads or offer. Let's take a moment to talk about the different keyword match types we can use with our search campaigns in Google Ads. As we've seen, when we add keywords, they're added as broad match by default. This match type provides the greatest coverage or reach for the keywords you are bidding on. As the name suggests, it's going to broadly match the keywords to what people are searching for on Google. So if we were bidding on chocolate gifts, our ads could appear as people search for chocolate gifts, Cadbury gift box, chocolate gift delivery, and chocolate shop Chicago. All of these search queries broadly relate to the keyword chocolate gifts. So this is the default match type in Google Ads. The next match type is phrase match. This is where we put the keywords we're bidding on inside quote marks. This tells Google Ads that we want those words to be included in what someone is searching for, or that someone should be searching for something with the same meaning. For example, chocolate gifts in quotes can match chocolate gifts for Father's Day, chocolate hamper, and chocolate gifts. This match type will match keywords with the same meaning, and phrase match is more targeted than broad match. This means our keyword will not match Cadbury gift box because this does not have the same meaning as the phrase match keyword. Then there is exact match. This is where we place our keyword inside square brackets. This will then match the keyword exactly. So chocolate gifts in square brackets will match chocolate gifts, but not chocolate golf gifts. It matches exactly. When we use exact match, phrase match, and broad keywords, it's important to understand that these will also match close variants. This means that Google Ads will automatically match singular and plural versions of our keywords, misspellings, and other close variations of keywords. For example, if we were bidding on the exact match keyword of chocolate gifts, then our ad would be displayed for people searching for chocolate gifts, chocolate gift singular, and the misspelling of chocolate gifts. So remember, close variants will apply to your exact match, phrase, and broad keywords. And close variants will ignore function words like to and for, and when the words are reordered, but retain the same meaning. Continuing our example of chocolate gifts, this exact match keyword could also mean our ads are displayed to people searching chocolate for gifts and gifts chocolate. These are also considered close variants. This brings us to our final keyword match type, negative match. Adding negative keywords is an important part of optimizing the performance of your campaigns. It's especially important to add negative keywords if you use broad match keywords. A negative match keyword prevents your ads from being displayed, which allows you to reduce the number of less relevant impressions. Here we can see we've added the negative keyword of ideas along with the broad match keyword of chocolate gifts. This means that people searching for chocolate gift ideas, ideas for chocolate gifts, and gift ideas won't see our ads. You will notice that our ads are still eligible to appear when someone searches for chocolate gift idea. If you don't want your ads to show for ideas singular and ideas plural, you will have to add both of these as negative keywords in Google Ads. This is because negative keywords don't work in the same way as broad match keywords. You need to be precise with negative keywords. When you're launching a new campaign and you don't want to spend your budget too quickly, I suggest using phrase or exact match keywords. And to really keep things controlled, you can begin with exact match and then adjust the match types after you've launched the campaign. Since I do want to have some slightly broader coverage, I'm going to change my keywords to phrase match by adding quote marks before and after each keyword. On the right, we can see an estimate for the number of clicks we might receive each week, the average cost per click, and the amount we'll need to spend. I find these estimates aren't always accurate, so use them as a general guide. You're likely to see different results once you've launched your campaign. Scrolling down, the next step is to create our first ad. The ad we're about to create is going to live inside the ad group. So this means we need to write an ad that closely relates to the keywords we've added to the ad group. We want to create an ad that is really going to engage with people as they're searching on Google. We're asked to create a responsive search ad. This type of ad lets us enter multiple headlines and descriptions. Google Ads will then combine up to 3 headlines and 2 descriptions to show people as they're searching on Google. It combines these elements automatically. To create our ad, we start by entering the landing page we want to send people to on our website. This needs to closely relate to the keywords we added to the ad group. I entered the landing page in the previous step, so we can see it's pre-filled with the URL for my Google Analytics glossary. I'm going to leave the display path, but you can also experiment by adding keywords here. Now I'm going to write headlines that closely relate to my offer and the keywords in the ad group. When you're writing the copy for your ads, you want to capture people's attention, be relevant, help them find the answers they're looking for, and lead them to your website. So take time to write your ad. Make it compelling. Now let's write the descriptions for our ad. Below this, we're prompted to add site links, callouts, and other assets to display with our ad. These assets were previously called ad extensions. We're going to leave these for now, and we will look at assets after we've created our campaign. So let's click Done. And now let's click Next. Now we're at the really important step, your budget. This is the number one way to control your advertising spend in Google Ads. If you set your budget too high, you'll end up being charged a lot for your campaign. So it's important to get this right and enter an amount you are comfortable spending. We can see Google Ads provides a recommended budget for our campaign. This is based on the settings we've selected and the keywords we've added. You can use this option, but let's select the option to set a custom budget. The budget is the average amount you want to spend each day. For example, setting a budget of $100 means that you'll be spending up to $3,040 a month. I recommend starting with a small budget, since you can increase this once your campaign is up and running. And my other tip is to set a budget that you're comfortable spending regardless of the results. This might sound strange, but as you start a new campaign, you'll need to spend some money to understand what works and what doesn't work. We're experimenting to refine our campaign. For my campaign, I'm comfortable spending around $300 a month, so I'm going to enter $10 as the daily budget. And just to highlight, this is an average. Some days, Google Ads will spend more than your daily budget amount, and other days it can spend less. Now that we've set our budget, let's click Next. We can now review the settings we've selected for our campaign. Since we've only selected a couple of keywords and we haven't configured assets, we can see some recommendations at the top. Let's go ahead and click Publish Campaign. We're not quite ready to launch our campaign yet, since we only have one ad group, three keywords, one ad, and we haven't created ad extensions. So what I want you to do is pause your campaign until you're ready to start spending the daily budget you entered. To do this, select Campaigns, and then Campaigns. We can see the campaign listed. Then I want you to click the green circle and select Pause. This will mean we can finish working on our campaign, and then when we're ready to start spending our budget, we can come back and enable the campaign. What are you going to promote with your new Google Ads campaign? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. In the next video, we're going to cover important interface features and how to use the Keyword Planner. And if you haven't already, please take a moment to subscribe to this channel so you're notified when the tutorial is released. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in my next video.